Hello friends, how are you? I hope you are fine. This video is based on the fourth part of the chapter, The Making of a Scientist. We have studied this chapter already in three parts. Now, in this video, we are going to discuss the question answers. I'm just going to tell you some points which you can write down in the exam to score good marks. Now, let's come to the first question which is asked in the book. How did a book become a turning point in Richard Everett's life? You have seen that his mother has given a book whose name was The Travels of Monarch 10. Okay, so this book was given by his mother. So the question is, how this book has become a turning point in Richard Everett's life? The turning point in Richard's life came when his mother bought him a children's book called The Travels of Monarch X. That book, which told how monarch butterflies migrate to Central America, opened the world of science to the eager young collector. So in this book, it has been described that how the monarch butterflies migrate to Central America from the North America, and this discovery has really opened the doors of the science. Next question is, how did his mother help him? Richard's mother helped him by encouraging his interest in learning. She took him on trips, bought him telescopes, microscopes, cameras, mounting materials and other equipment to help him learn. Now, the mother was very well aware that my son is very curious and very eager in learning the new things and in gaining more and more information. So, what the mother did? The mother has given each and all every opportunity to the child to score his own world. Next question is, what lesson does Everett learn when he does not win anything at a science fair? The lesson that Everett learns when he does not win anything at a science fair is that one needs to do real experiments to catch people's attention and win instead of presenting just a neat display. For the first time, when Richard has participated in the county science fair, he did not get any award. Neither he got any recognition. Why? Because earlier he thought that science is nothing, but later on when the other people got their awards in the same science fair, he realized that how I was different from other people. Other people have done some experiments. Now, what is an experiment? An experiment is a series of actions which is done and later on you get the result. You get the consequence. So, after contributing in the county science fair, he realized that science is means or science is real experiments. When you do the experiments, then only you can attract the attention of the people and you can get the world recognition. Next question, what experiments and projects does he then undertake? The subject he knew most was about the insect work he had been doing in the past several years. He wrote to Dr. Yukart for ideas, who sent back a stack of suggestions for experiments. For his 8th grade project, Everett tried to find the cause of a viral disease that kills nearly all monarch caterpillars every few years. Next year, his science fair project was testing the theory that viceroy butterflies copy monarch butterflies. Richard's project was to see whether in fact birds would eat monarchs. In his second year in high school, Richard began the research that led to his discovery of an unknown insect hormone. Indirectly, it also led to his new theory on the life of cells. As a high school junior, Richard Everett continued his advanced experiments on the monarch pupa. In his senior year, he grew cells from a monarch's wing in a culture and showed that the cells would divide and develop into normal butterfly wing scales only if they were fed the hormone from the gold spots. So these all were the experiments and the projects which were undertaken by Richard. Next question is, what are the qualities that go into the making of a scientist? What qualities, what ingredients are required in becoming a scientist? The qualities that go into the making of a scientist are a first-rate mind, curiosity, and the will to win for the right reasons. Now, you are intelligent, that is not sufficient. Even if you are intelligent, but still if you don't have the curiosity, the eagerness to learn new things, to gain new information, how can you move forward in life? So a scientist must not be interested in winning for winning's sake or winning to get a prize. He must win because he wants to do the best job he can. Now, whatever projects were undertaken by Richard, he had not undertaken those projects only for the sake of winning, to get something, to get some award, to get the prize. No. He has undertaken these projects to give his 100% result. He thought that whatever I do in life, I should be totally involved in that and even I should be successful in that. Means he expected 100% result from whatever action he did in his life. Next question is, how can one become a scientist, an economist, a historian? Does it simply involve reading many books on the subject? Does it involve observing, thinking, and doing experiments? So the question is, how can one become a scientist or an economist or a historian? Only that we read the books or we gain knowledge, we can become these people. Or does it involve observing, thinking, and doing experiments? To become a scientist, an economist, or historian, one simply cannot stop at reading many books on the subject. It involves observing, thinking, and doing experiments. First of all, one has to make and record clear observations on the subject. One has to think carefully about the process, and based on studies and observations through experiments, draw logical conclusions. The authentication of experiments must be backed by concrete proof, and every step needs to be clearly recorded. If you want to be a scientist or if you want to be a historian, you cannot speak out the things. Don't you think that if I'll just speak out the things, the people will believe? No. You have to prove your points. Only after proving your points or whatever you want to show, you have to prove. Then only people can believe you. So these were some of the questions which I have discussed in this video. I hope you have understood them. Now, the next video, we will come with some other chapter. Thank you.